everybody. It's your good buddy 650 Eve here, and yet another windy day in the beautiful city of Detroit. I'm here at Ducati Detroit, and you guys know why I'm here. Today is the day that I bring home my beautiful babies. This one, the 2013 1199 Panigale R. Taking it home today. It had some engine mods done to it. This bike is supposed to be faster than it was. We're going to definitely find out about that after I break it in. And then my brand new Ducati V4 Speciale. Now everybody and their mother and their daughters and their children and family have made their unboxing videos on the V4, V4S, and even the Speciales at this point. But I think I'm going to beat everyone to the punch by installing a brand new set of BST Rapid Tech carbon fiber wheels onto my Speciale here today. Here we go. This is my first time seeing these wheels too. They are BST Rapid Tech carbon fiber wheels, gloss finish. Now, whoa, equally stunning is the rear wheel. And this is pretty much what you'll see because the V4 has a single-sided swing arm, so all of that precious carbon fiber will be exposed. So here we have a brand new $12.99 Superleggera with stock carbon fiber wheels. These are also made by BST, and you can see they look great. The finish on these are not glossy, they're matte finish. And then right next to it, you have my glossy finished Rapid Tech wheel. I know the lighting here is not that great, but you can definitely see that the design is somewhat similar. There we go. Ducati would not allow them to replicate the design from the Superleggera, but it's pretty close. All right, my good buddy Connor is going to weigh these wheels for us. This is the front wheel, BST Rapid Tech. Digital scale, 6 pounds, 33 ounces. Is that about right, Connor?
Yep.
6 pounds, 3 ounces. All right, so Connor has returned with the stock wheel from the V4 Speciale. Let's see how much it weighs. Oh, wow. 7 pounds, 5 ounces.
Yeah, saving well over a pound in weight.
Well over a pound. To be 5 pounds, 6 ounces. 5 pounds, 6 ounces from the rear wheel. The stock rear wheel, let's see how much it weighs. It weighs 8 pounds and 0.5 of an ounce. And the BST wheel weighs 5 pounds, 6 ounces.
So what we're looking at in the BST is not even total weight, but where the weight is placed at. So we have a lot of rigidity in the BST in the center part of the wheel. Towards the outside is where they lose a lot of weight, and that's centrifugal rotational mass. So if you ever had those little spinning toys when you're a kid and you know you rolled it back and forth and you try turning it, that centrifugal force keeps you upright and keeps you from really wanting to turn. And that's the one thing that the BST has advantage over even a premium aluminum forged Marcassini wheel.
Wow, I'm impressed. Not to mention they look 1,000 times better. But I guess that could be opinionated.
These are a great looking wheel also still.
They are.
Best looking factory looking wheel there is, in my opinion.
Agreed. So here we are, the moment of truth. The unboxing of my 2018 Ducati V4 Speciale. It's already had its prep done, so it's out of the crate. And the only thing that I have to do now is remove this film here from the windshield. And that is about the gist of my unboxing of this motorcycle. It's a great bike. I haven't ridden it yet. I'm waiting to ride it with Five Up here, who's actually filming this. And in just a few moments, we're going to remove these bikes, put them in our trailer. We want to talk to you guys about the stuff that comes with the Speciale. As you can see, it has a stock exhaust on it right now, okay? But it does come with the full titanium Akrapovic exhaust. And Steve and I have decided to have these exhausts installed after we do our first service and break-in, and after we do a stock dyno comparison to show you what these bikes make completely stock. Okay, the bike also comes with a cover, which is pretty cool. Motorcycle cover, Ducati. And this really cool thing, it's a mock-up scaled image of the engine, the V4 engine, and it has the number of your particular Speciale as well. Mine is number 253, Steve's is 233. We do not have the same bike, as you'll see in a moment when we're riding them together. And it also, I just broke mine. Sure I'll be able to fix that. Okay. And it also comes with a tall windscreen.
Yeah, it's a Corsa.
Corsa windscreen?
Yeah, much taller.
We'll have this thing installed when they do the exhaust. So that's that. Special thanks to Ducati Detroit, Charlie, Connor, Kevin, with the gorgeous hair. Everybody here has been really helpful, really great. Steve, who's filming, has been great too. But without further ado, we're going to get the heck out of here and do some riding.
Hey, I'm so pretty. I'm on Gucci. I'm so pretty. I'm gonna get it. Watch me move.
All right, so as you can see, we finally made it back to Steve's house from Ducati Detroit. And Steve actually is riding his bike before me. straight through his driveway. But I'm hopping on my bike for the first time here, guys. First thing I want to do is make sure my mirrors are set, and it looks like they're looking good.
What mirrors?
Oh, yeah, Steve took his mirrors off. Yeah. Oh, bike feels good, man. The rear sets feel great. There we go. So this will be our first ride on the Ducati. Wow, I like it. It went into night mode just by going through your garage.
Yeah, immediately.
Yep. You guys see that? The gauges turn black on white.
Yep.
And they'll probably turn white on black again a little bit.
Mine hasn't yet.
Okay. And your headlight's on now, too.
Thing ride stiff in race mode.
First ride. Oh, Ducati V4. What a goddamn blast! Oh man. Auto Vision works great. Wow, the gauges look like a freaking Lamborghini Aventador, man.
Yeah, it's unbelievable what the gauges look like.
You can definitely tell that they have some Audi, Volkswagen, influence. Steve, dude, we already have gone a quarter of a mile, and I can tell you this bike feels great, man. How does yours feel, man?
I'm still trying to figure it out. I'm seeing where the gear indicator's at. I'm seeing, watching the tach. The gear indicator's actually huge on this thing, right in the center of the tachometer.
Yeah. I'm gonna smack Steve down so bad! Okay. I knew he'd start his shenanigans real soon. This bike feels great, man. Reminds me of my Ninja H2 when I rode it for the first time. Just the burst of speed this bike has. And just, oh man, what a f***ing feeling. Man, I'm thoroughly impressed. This bike is leaps and bounds ahead of my 1199R.
Yeah, I definitely am feeling the width. The smoothness and the power delivery is unbelievably smooth compared. But listen to me now. I'm going to compare this back to my S1000. it still feels like there's character going on in between my legs. I'm not talking about that beautiful blonde girl that, you know, you only keep around for a few months and then she goes away for good reason. She acts right and she's beautiful behind closed doors, and I can definitely tell that right now in how the throttle delivery of the bike is heavily emissionized.
Yeah.
Basically full of emissions right now. This thing is choked up.
Yes. And yet it still delivers flawless, effortless, immediate throttle response. Wow. Wow. And your taillights look great too. I guess I better get used to seeing those taillights, eh?
Yes.
Yes, sir. I accept my station in life, sir. All right, so we got our first stop for fuel here. We're not sure how much fuel the bikes came with, so we're just going to top off before we get on the highway. Come on over here, Steve. And we have a tradition, well, at least Steve and I do, that one man pays for fuel. Saves time. That way two people don't have to get out and do that. So I'll get it this time. Steve will get it next time. So, Steve, this interesting thing here we have. Oh, cool. Let's put this thing in here.
Make sure we got fuel. So we're making sure we have fuel.
Okay, cool. Where do you sit yours at, Steve, when you're...
I don't know.
Right here on the triple treat is a little spot for it.
Yeah, I think it kind of sets right in there nicely.
Yeah, as long as it doesn't scratch anything. But I tell you guys what, man, I just love this bike. It's the same feeling that I had when I got my my H2. Except this bike isn't violent, doesn't want to kill me, it doesn't seem like. We'll see how these tires hold up in the rain.
Yeah.
Well, everybody, the Diablo Supercrossa tires are holding up to the rain very nicely. It is a very hard downpour, and we're on the highway cruising around 90 miles an hour. I have good traction. Steve is having some traction issues.
Yeah, just when I hit the concrete there, it's not like it.
Yeah.
Trying to keep my camera out of the water.
Yeah, me too.
So, after getting caught in a torrential downpour of epic proportion, we are back at Steve's residence and we're about to clean these things off. Steve, your first impressions in under 2 minutes of your new V4 Speciale.
I love the power delivery, how smooth it is. There really is no change in how the power comes on. The bike is just smooth throughout the power band. It feels even more nimble and flickable than my 1299.
Wow, it's in the living room. Yeah.
Yeah. So, I mean, I'm very impressed with it so far.
My impressions on my V4 Speciale is I absolutely love this motorcycle. You heard my... Oh, look at my horrible wheels! Oh my God! Did you see that?
No.
Yeah. Yeah, you guys can clearly see what the heck we just went through, and it's a good idea that Steve has us swinging these bikes right now. But anyway, I love my V4 Speciale. These tires, Pirelli Supercourses, the new ones, 60 series tires, held up in the rain pretty nicely. We were cruising at speeds in excess of XXX miles per hour, and they held up really good. The bike overall, really nice, comfortable. Quick shifter, auto blipper, work great. And I did feel a little bit of heat coming from this side right here, these exhaust pipes. But it wasn't enough to make me want to jump off the bike and kick it down the road and douse myself in water or anything like that.
Barely 80
degrees
here today, too, in Michigan. So yeah. It wasn't like it was a 50-degree day and we felt heat.
Yeah. So. 80 degrees, as Steve just said. So cool. I hope you enjoyed my unboxing, first ride, first mod, smackdown video on the Ducati V4. Stay tuned for many, many, many more videos from me and 5UP on these outstanding motorcycles. Our verdict is in. We love these bikes as we knew we would, and we are very, very, very impressed. So hit the like button if you enjoyed the video. You can subscribe to my channel by clicking the subscribe button. Subscribe to 5UP's channel by clicking on the link in the description. New videos are always uploaded to both of our channels. And this is Steve's 1299 and a Vossario. Stay tuned for more videos. And as always, thanks for viewing. And don't forget, we're going to add a lot more mods onto these bikes real soon. But for right now, I'm going to clean it up because she is filthy. We'll catch you next time.